Yeah, Smart Board Games here. Let's play PT Boats South Gambit. Yeah, we already checked out the original, the first title, and this here is a successor or a standalone expansion. Expanding into the Med and the Black Sea, including Soviet, British, German, and Italian PT boats, but also other ships. You can, those ships are simulated in a higher degree, but you can also command destroyers. Game runs fine on Windows 10 11, even with pretty good graphics, high resolutions. Only thing I failed to activate, but I think that was already for the other game, is dynamic shadows. Perhaps that is also on purpose, because it might be not running or might crashing. There was something I remember when checking the original about one setting. And there's also a way to activate it. Anyways. Yeah, game comes as a tutorial and yeah, two campaigns. I mean, you can play from any side, but it's always the same missions. Just assume the other faction. Normally you need to unlock them, but there is a easy modification to a config file in case you don't want to unlock all those missions. You need to succeed in order to play the next, and also in order to operate in the Black Sea, you first, I guess, need to complete the Med. Good. I think the tutorial offers a good introduction to have some peace time in order to check out graphics and the boats. It is not a full-fledged simulation, it is rather something I would call simcade or sim action, yeah, in middle between an action game and a simulation. But probably probably your best bet even if you want to play something on with PT boats, at least 3D video game. And for board game there is a solitaire game.
Congratulations! You are now the captain of a torpedo boat. Torpedo boats are small but can be very dangerous. You'll get a chance to see it for yourself. It is a training mission, so there must be no casualties. It's an order. Your first mission is to intercept an enemy convoy and simulate its destruction. It's quite easy, even in a real combat situation. A friendly will go ahead of you and show you the course. You control your boat by pressing W, S, A, and D keys. The W and S keys change the speed of the boat, while A and D keys change its course. The position and the course of friendly and hostile ships are shown on the radar. Friendly units are green and hostile units are red. The power and the speed of the unit are shown near its symbol. The number of your crew members and the damage indicators are to the left of the speedometer. If you lose all your crew, you lose the boat as well. Now follow me. is the friendly ship. The convoy is ahead of you. Full speed ahead. Remember, a torpedo boat can be armed with guns of small and medium caliber. Small caliber guns are placed alongside the boards. The medium ones are located in the bow and the stern. The exact number and position of the guns depend on the modification of the boat. You can take the position of a gun. To do it, press 1 or 2. You can return to the previous view by pressing 1. By pressing 1 or 2 again, you select another gun of the same caliber. You can use aimed fire by pressing the right mouse button. The information about the remaining ammo and the temperature of the gun is provided in the right part of the screen. Do not allow the gun to overheat.
Captain, I would like to remind you that this mission is as close as it can be to a real combat situation.
Great. The convoy is dead ahead. Get in range of the three cables from the nearest boat and identify them. To do it, use the binoculars. Switch to the bridge by pressing 4 and then press and hold the right mouse button. Hold the right mouse button and keep the target in the field of vision until it has been identified. Three cables, 600 meters. Now commence the attack. Torpedo boat can carry from 2 to 4 torpedoes. To select the torpedo sight, press 4 several times until a torpedo symbol appears in the left corner of the
screen. Guten Tag.
Roll the mouse wheel to select a target.
Can you pick those guys up?
After you have selected a target, right-click to switch to the aiming menu. All you need to do is to position the boat so the mark in the center of the screen is aligned with the mark on the target. You can fire a torpedo by pressing the spacebar. If you need to launch a torpedo fast, you can do it in the third-person view.
Great. The Navy needs more officers like you, Captain. Well, that's it for today.
Welcome to the squadron. Today you're going to study the tactical planning and work as part of a group. Press Enter to switch to the tactical mode. You can return to the simulation mode by pressing Enter one more time. This is 3D tactical mode. The two-dimensional minimap is on the left part of the screen, and the command panel is on the right part of the screen. Some commands may be inactive. It means that you cannot use them at the moment. At the top, there are buttons that change the game speed. The panel with the ship list and the information about the selected ship is in the center. Some of the ships may be under your command. The list of the ships that you can give orders to is in the middle of the tactical interface. In this case, two torpedo boats are under your command. You can get information about the damage and the crew for each ship. The selected unit is marked by a green circle. The weapons panel is in the middle. The available weapons depend on the class of the ship. The course of the ship is denoted by a green arrow. You can order the ship to move by selecting it and right-clicking on a point on the map. You can assign checkpoints for the ship to go through. To do it, press and hold Control and select the checkpoints by clicking on the map. The ship is going to move through the checkpoints automatically. The direction is marked by a blue line. If you want to delete a checkpoint, press and hold Control and click on the checkpoint. In some cases, you may give orders not only to the boats, but to the other ships in the squadron as well. You can give orders individually or to several ships at the same time. Now we're going to work on formations. Select all the ships. The list of the formations will appear on the right panel. Now order the squadron to move to the northwest. Order the squadron to form a line. Select all the ships and click on the line button.
Yeah, you can also command bigger ships, like destroyers, corvettes, but to a lesser degree, you can't use the guns, but only indirect control. 2. Schwede, das ist ein T-44-Turret.
Ja.
They installed 2 T-44-Turrets on that PT-Boat. Yeah, some of those pity boats are quite slow. Okay, they're also bringing in PT boats. Give those guys waypoints. Let's fight those other PT boats. Video too far. Those guys are too slow, give them time. Retreat behind those T-34 PT boats. TKA-16 is already taking heavy damage. Yeah, link up with that guy. That is my Tony. Yeah, convoy in front of us. Big one. A lot of ships. This one seems to be closer. One warship, two freighters it seems. This another one with one warship. And yeah, hard to tell, but probably two freighters. The other one will be taken by the Germans. We will focus on that one here. What happened? Oh, lost control. Good, we will definitely focus on the cargo ships. You will attack this rear one. You will. Yeah, we might fire some torpedoes at the destroyers in order to put him onto evasive. That is my boat. Yeah, that is the Germans. Okay. That is the plan, go. Good luck. And good hunting. engaging us. Do I have a smoke screen now? Did you? Ah, he dropped the torpedoes, okay. Okay, I'm about to, but I will go closer. God damn it. That looks good. Torpedo impact. Get behind the smoke screen. We are the only one that made it out. It seems. Good, but both transport are sunk. I don't have information about the warship, but I suspect it survived. Okay, now it is time for the Germans. Oh no, seems like we... Ah, because of our radio failed. Could be that is the reason. There was a second convoy in that direction. Yeah, you can also drop depth charges here in this game. Yeah, submarine, anti-submarine warfare is somewhat very arcadey. There's usually always some. That's how you look. How it looks if you drop a death charge. Actually, that is quite close. Mike, brother, leave Gunnery to my man.